Tell them the story.
Yeah, the story's part of the song. The story's actually the first verse, just without music. We have a Monday night song circle from Walks Ahead to actually how I met Stan, so it's a good thing. But we were playing, and one night the host's wife, Ronnie, came in, and she's from Australia, and in this beautiful Australian accent, she says, "All the songs y'all play are so depressed. I feel like I'm going to go upstairs and stick my head in an oven." So,
kitchen's upstairs.
So,
yeah, we were ignoring the song.
So, anyway, the next day, I went to the shop and wrote the song. Came home last night to knock on the door. Said you were leaving, won't be back anymore. Says you were tired of all my sad songs. So I wrote this for you, 'cause you are gone. It's my happy, 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 happy song. I was drunk when I wrote it, so it didn't take that long. And I'll be writing many more now that you're gone, 'cause I like singing happy, happy songs. So it's my happy, 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 happy song. I was drunk when I wrote it, so it didn't take that long.
Song before,
and
probably most of you that have.
Thank you, Gary. That has to be the stupidest song I've ever heard in my life. You know something? You could be right. Certainly not going to get any argument out of me. But hey, you think I want to write songs like this? No way. I want to write songs like Lennon and McCartney and Dylan and Diamond. No. So then the obvious question is, why did you write it? Well, I'll tell you. The same reason that tonight, when you're laying in your bed,